Hello everyone, welcome again to part 3. These are the projects that I received in a Valentine swap from Brigitta. Thank you so much again, Brigitta. And I'm going to open up the last goodies and the gifts that she tucked in her package for me. So I'm so excited. If you haven't seen the two parts, go ahead, go and watch them. And then come back to this last part, which is the part where I share the last item that we agreed to swap on. And that's a memory dex card, a 3D memory dex card. Thank you so much for that embellishment there, sort of a brooch, an envelope brooch. And as I open her up, I cannot wait to share what's inside. Today is a very bright and sunny day, so I took the advantage of that and started to filming this. And as I said, this is a voiceover. I already opened up all the yummy goodies that she gifted me, but because of the noise, distortion in the noise of my voice, so I had to record this all over again as a voiceover. And as you see, I am unpacking all the gifts, but the voice is a voiceover. So that's. I hope it says enough for you. So this is the embellishing box that Brigitta created. As you can see, she added lots of layering, beautiful dye there. And in the middle, she used a beautiful bling brooch, which I loved. I already asked her for that. She said she received that as a gift. She did stitch the buttons, but then she glued them on to the trim. And that's such a great idea as well. And do you see all the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful layering again here? And it's a close-up of the bling piece that I love so much. That's there. And she also mentioned that all the words, wooden veneer pieces, she did those with a Nouveau drop and her glitter. So as I opening it up, you can see the beautiful pattern paper there of the Simple Stories, again with some lace on the sides. You can see all the yummy goodies that she tucked in inside. And I'll share them with you as I can, one by one. In this first compartment, she added in some beads that I can wire wrap myself. I have tried that a few times. It is a bit difficult, but with some tutorials, it can be done. And these are the, I was showing you that she used those beads also on a previous projects that she created for me. I was looking for that, but I couldn't find that in immediately. So I'll show them later on. But I just love the colors that she she gave me in this box. Taking out just a few smaller parts, and I just love the colors, the bright ones, and especially the bling ones, of course. Sorry, because I love the bling. In this next compartment, there's a lot of resin pieces, various pieces like this bear. This one as well. This is especially the one that I haven't seen around, so I was very lucky to have received one of those. And I'm taking out some more of those as well to show you what's inside that compartment. Then I'll go to the next one, which has some metal dangles, a tassel there, scissor, all kinds of different themes are inside this compartment. I believe this is sort of ivory look elephant, and dangled there, sort of beautiful print on that as well. Lots of snowy embellishments, silver dangles. So yeah, I can really use these as well in my upcoming projects, as I also will be creating for Christmas throughout this year. So these charms will work well on the various projects that I'm working on. So I just wanted to show you one of the favorites in this compartment. I will tuck them in again and show you the next compartment, which has some sort of dimensional resin pieces, as well as this beautiful, these hearts. And this is quite a special item. I believe this is a sort of a capsule, and the capsule has a paper inside, and I was opening it up because I was very curious if it had something written on the piece of paper. But I can use this myself to send a message, of course, a secret message in that capsule. Yeah, I believe maybe you have seen one of these before, but this was the first time for me to receive one of those. So it was quite a great surprise. This is another one that I haven't opened up. And these are the other resin pieces. I love that candy. That candy and those bows are going to be used in a future project that I'm working on for my niece. And I'm using the collection Cute Girl for that, from the AC Digitals, or the crepe paper. And I can't wait to share that with you in the next upcoming videos. Here are some handmade flowers that I also used in a banner that I sent off to Brigitte. And I'll put, of course, the link down below to that banner that I created for her as well, using quite a few of the embellishment that she sent me in this swap. So that's the great thing if you swap it with your friends. They know you so well. So they always send you perfect gifts and perfect things to use, and as well as beautiful colors and new add-ons to your stash. Some of them, of course, you can see here, are so teeny tiny, so they are perfect for cards as well. And I cannot wait to start creating with those. These are the last few paper flowers that are in this compartment, and I'm sure quite a lot of you have already tried creating this these flowers as well. They are just perfect to add on to different kind of projects that you're working on. Just loving these sequences that are on the bottom. They have a few different colors. We have this sort of a light pink, a hot pink, and a red one. And this trim is still hoarded in my embellishment fold. I still haven't used that yet, but these are perfect, especially the white one. You can use alcohol markers on those. These two bows, I already sent that off again to Brigitte. She has that on the banner, as well as a few of these paper roses. I just love that. For the last compartment, I will show you the sort of a trinkets compartment, where she put in different metallic pieces. And these are always a great add-on to my stash, because I use them so much. So I'm always running out of these, and I want to share with you the favorite piece of this trinket compartment. I just love these numbers. They are so cute, and I also outgrowed them. These are really hoarded by me. So let me share with you what she has more in the trinket compartment. Yeah, just teeny tiny pieces as well, as I will share with you in a moment. And just these pieces that I believe she made those herself. The images are glued in, I believe. But if I'm not right, please correct me. This is one of the teeny tiny items that I was telling you about. This is such a cute paperclip. I don't have that size at all. And these are just perfect if you want to create your own dangle using resin pieces. This is just a perfect way to use that. So this is the last compartment. I'll be tucking in all the flowers back again. And thank you so much again for that, Brigitta. And as you can see, I still have a few items there, a few gifts. So I'll be opening up this one. And I believe this one is going to be the last swap item, which is the 3D or three-dimensional memory decks card. And it's a sort of a bag that pops up, and in that bag you can of course put anything that you would love. And she created a tech flip for me in this one. So this is how it looks like. This is the front. She added quite a few layers, which I love. And I'll take out the tech flip and I'll show you around. This is the back using breads as well, as I did. And this is the tech flip. She used a lot of variation of papers. Also from the Simple Stories collection, but also from, this is something that I wanted to share with you. This is the inside. As I told you, the die, the shaker die, she created that into a dangle. So she used quite a lot of different papers, as I was telling you about. And this is what she said in a video, one of her favorite dies that surprised her, because she ordered it just for the envelopes, actually. But the total die was so cute that she fell in love with those. This bottle cap that she embellished herself. And this is one of her hoarded flowers that she got from Patricia. And she also, I can understand, because it has so many beautiful layers, vellum papers. She has holographic paper. Sorry for that. And quite a few of different textures. So I also made a rose like this and sent it off to her, so her fold will be filled again with a flower like that. And this is such a cute banner, a label, and a great idea to tuck in something like this in the back. So I'll tuck it in and share with you the next gift. So I am hoping everyone is doing okay and enjoying this video as well. I have uploaded two previous videos, so if you haven't seen them, go over there and watch them first and then come back again, or just join along and watch this video, of course. And I just love that rosette that I showed you. And this is also a handmade basket. And it's such a sturdy basket, such a great idea as well to display some gifts in. I believe this handle is made with paper, sort of a washi tape, but it's of course a fabric. A tape. And on the inside she also has a beautiful piece of fabric t- tucked, and then there's some beautiful flowers with buttons. Now she has a detailed video of this project as well, so I will put the links down below. And if you need more information, just let me know. So this is a close-up of the beautiful bow that she created, two-layered bow. I just love that paper that she used, the silver colored paper. Super, super cute. And then I will be sharing with you the gifts. Again, a beautiful package that she reused and tucked in some handmade flowers herself. So that's, yeah, that's just super cute. The embellishment box had the smaller ones, and this is the larger piece. So these are the larger pieces. And then I will be opening up this one, which is a Nouveau. And I just love this color. I don't have this color in my stash yet, but I do love the Nouveau, so I am going to certainly use this in the future projects. So be on the lookout for that as well. And I have like two colors of the Nouveau drops, but I still have to practice. Those drops of mine are still not really as beautiful as the ones that Brigitta created. But yeah, I have to practice a lot, so that's okay. And this is a candy, so the heart-shaped salted licorice. And I just love this one. I had to try it out, so I already tasted how it's the flavor. And it went into the candy jar, but it didn't stay there for a very long time, because we all enjoyed the salt licorice. So yeah, so I'm very happy to have received those two. And now I'm going to open up the Crafter's Companion paper that she sent me. And I cannot wait to share those with you. She wrapped them really well, and the size of this bag is really well as well, so I'm going to store that and use indeed for some snippets that I have of paper, or if I'm working on the new project, then I'll be storing them in there, so I can grab it and use it when I'm working again on the project. So this is the first paper, and I just love the color. You can see it. It's sort of a powdery, dusty, shabby color. And it has beautiful patterns on them. Beautiful colors, beautiful printouts, loving the roses. And the quality of the paper is really well as so I think I have a project in mind for this. And this one is one of my favorites as well. I'm just loving the butterflies. This is the back of that one. And this rose, look at this super cute rose pattern here. Just perfect, perfect for, of course, fussy cutting, but of course for journaling tags, because this is the back. And this is such a beautiful denty print that you you can use for lots of different projects. And this is the one of the last pages that are in this paper bag. I believe she has they have different prints on the backs. So that varies. And this one is also super cute. And for the die cut pieces, these are the, you can just punch them out, and they have all kinds of labels on them, some clusters. And also, I just loving the prints that are on the different kind of tags there, and the sort of postage stamps. Just super cute. And this bee is so super beautiful. I just love that one as well. As well as these patterns all through. So these are all the beautiful, beautiful goodies that Brigitta created for me. And again, if you haven't seen the part one and two, just go ahead and open them up. And thank you so much again, Brigitta, for being my swap partner. And of course, for being my crafty sisters for such a long time. I know we haven't seen each other in real life, but we still have our Yitzi meetings. So yeah, thank you so much again for watching everyone. And Brigitta, have a wonderful day. All of you have a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you all soon. And yeah, just wishing you a great day. Bye bye.